Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is very great privilege of me to present you the subject under the training program sampling gear. I was assigned by our project director to provide you the information on the Tronet used as sampling gear in the fishery resource survey. My name is Isala Charachakit. I work at Research and Development Division, Southeast Asian Fishery Development Center, or CFDEC, Training Department. Today, it is very, very, very good to inform you the Tronet, various kind of Tronet that can use for survey. First of all, I would like to provide you the outline of my presentation today. Is composed with the background of the subject, definition of trawl fishing, classification of trawl fishing, construction of trawl net is very important, is very significant for the survey. Trawl net that used in CFDEC, we will raise few model to show you. And standard operational procedure for trawl fishing, trawl survey, including with fishing operation, fishing record, catch handling, fishing log sheet. And the last one is linked with our presentation in following subject, is the estimate efficiency of the gear, meaning is estimate the net opening and net width that used in resource abundance. Come to the first, talking about the background of this subject. The trawl net for sampling, we both know that it is used in fishery resource survey. Almost every country use the trawl for research abundance. It is coming from the marine fishery. Resource is very important for economic and social, not only in Southeast Asia but in the world, that contribute a good livelihood. And we found that in the past several decades, the starting on declining of fishery resources, it is maybe coming from the development and modernization of the fishing technology and resolve overfishing. Over-exploited in not only demersal resources, but also pelagic resources. And every country needs management. And the management, the first part of management is data collection. If data collection inaccurate, you cannot manage your resource effectively. So with that, we need to improve. We need to improve the data collection. One of the improvement is selecting appropriate sampling gear or sampling devices. And the problem is we mostly of us not so familiarized with the fishing gear. Only fishing technologies they understand well. But researcher, no. We are focusing on the cash. We are focusing on the resource. We leave the sampling gear technique for fishing technologies. With that, this subject coming to have objective for enhanced human resource capacity building for junior staff or young researcher who involved with the fishery resource survey. We would like to provide information of the trawl fishing net, trawl fishing operation, for the young scientists. If you are expert on the fishing gear, if you are specialist on the fishing techniques, you may not suitable for this subject because you may know much more than the topic or scope of the subject. With that, the details will not go in depth of the fishing gear design. Just only roughly on the trawl fishing net, trawl fishing gear that used in the survey. The next slide, before going to the model of the trawl, I would like to provide you the definition of trawl net, trawl fishing. Definition of trawl fishing and trawl net consists of the conning shape crossed by the back, and the cut end is extended by the wing. It means if conical shape of net lay down in the horizontal and drag into the water column, sea columns, or bottom seabed. That is definition by FAO. Trawl net can trawl by two boat, can trawl by single boat, can use the equipment to expand the mouth of the trawl, or even use the beam. I will inform you in the following part of this presentation. One of the most important principle of trawl raised by Mr. Bandit Chok Songwon, our trawl instructor, he referred to Dr. Baranov in 1977, the textbook of the trawl fishing net. Trawl net different from the seine net. Someone may confuse. Seine net construction almost same with the trawl, but the trawl fishing or trawl net fishing, it need to trawl in distance longer than 5 times of the total length of the net. Meaning if from the opening part until the cut end part is 50 meters, trawl net, trawl fishing must operate in the distance longer than 250 meters. If the trawl operate only 100 meters, 200 meters, it is not, we don't call it trawl fishing. We call it seine fishing. Example of seine fishing is Danish seine, Scottish seine, beach seine is a part of the seine fishing. That different classification of the fishing gear with the trawl. So that management of both gear may different. That depends on country. Definition of trawl net, I provide you more focus on the net is the cone shape and operate in the bottom or mid water, horizontal opening, and the gear may open, the mouth may open by beam, we call beam trawl, by outboard, we call outboard trawl, by two vessel, we call patrol. The height of the net can open by float and weight by heavy weight, maybe chains, lead, rock, rubber, made it vertical opening. And mid size of the trawl is very important. It's special design for regulate size of fish and selected the size of the fish. With that, when we make management measure on the fishing gear, we always focus on the mid size of cut end. Suppose in Thailand, the mid size regulation is for 40 millimeters for cut end. Malaysia is around 38 millimeters cut end. And The next slide, I would like to show you that classification of trawl in each country is different. You can see in the screen, Thailand classify the trawl by operation, pair trawl, bottom outboard trawl, beam trawl, and within bottom outboard trawl, fish trawl, shrimp trawl, acetate trawl, jellyfish. Malaysia is classified almost same as Thailand, but a bit different in Malaysia have bottom double rigging trawl. It look like Mexican shrimp trawl. Vietnam, almost same as Thai. The most different one is, I would like to show you Indonesia. Indonesia has various kind of trawl, and Indonesia have midwater trawl in the classification of trawl net, trawl fishing. And one of the most interesting for Indonesia is Pukat Dorong. Pukat Dorong is push net. The classification of fishing gear in the fishing catalog of Indonesia include the push net in the trawl fishing gear, so that management may different among each country. But FAO classify is quite broad, because FAO need to provide information all over the world, international classification, including with beam trawl, outboard trawl, single trawl, twin outboard, multiple outboard, bottom pair trawl, bottom trawl that not include in from 1 to 5 type. FAO put 9 other than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and single boat midwater trawl. Another is midwater trawl, midwater pair trawl, semi-pelagic trawl is one of the new name that we recognize. Semi-pelagic trawl meaning of it is the high opening trawl. In Malaysia, you call crocodile trawl. In Thailand, high opening pair trawl. That can include in the type of semi-pelagic trawl. The next slide, we are provide definition of the pelagic trawl and midwater trawl. You may confuse. In actually, construction is same. You can use midwater trawl net operate in the surface area few meter from the surface and catch focus on anchovy, catch focus on sardine. That called pelagic trawl. But when you operate deeper than it, deeper than the surface layer, just from the layer that few meters until the few meter above the sea bottom, that can call midwater trawl. And sometimes we confuse, but I have experience in working with the Norwegian trawlers, Norwegian research vessels, FRV, RV Fishop Nansen. They use midwater trawl, the same model, but operate in the surface by putting a lot of float, big float, to catch the squid near sea surface. And then we call it the pelagic trawl. With that, please don't confuse model net plan, net construction, trawl net diagram, may same between midwater trawl and pelagic trawl. Just only area of the operation is different. And midwater trawl have outboard trawl or pair trawl, depends. And certainly, midwater pair trawl must be size is bigger than midwater outboard trawl. And for the demersal trawl or bottom trawl is the same name. If you visit the website of SeaFish, www.seafish.org, SeaFish call bottom trawl is demersal trawl. Don't worry about the model. Don't worry about the net plan. It's same. Just only name is different. And yes, bottom trawl same have outboard or bottom pair trawl or even bottom beam trawl. Bottom beam trawl always used for catch the chim. I will explain later. But we have midwater beam trawl. And actually we have midwater beam trawl, but it's used for scientific work only. It will not use in, we never seen it used in commercial. The next one, I would like to inform you the definition of beam trawl. Beam trawl, yes, net model is same. It look like conical shape, operate, lay down, horizontal lay down in the seabed and drag by the boat. How can we call it beam trawl? Beam trawl, the mouth opening, horizontal opening is opened by using the beam made by small one made by wood, the big trawler made by metal, steel beam. Beam is start from small few meters, 3 meters, 4 meters, until the biggest one is 12 meters length of beam. And vertical opening beam trawl in European beam trawl, the opening provided by the two hoop like made by steel, so that opening is not high, maybe 1 meters, not higher than, because the target catch is shrimp and flat fish, prawn, crab that stay at the seabed. Beam trawl in Thailand, vertical opening, they use the float, similar to regular trawl, regular outboard trawl, use the float. They don't use the what we call the hoop like metal to open, vertical open the trawl net, different from the European. And I'm not so sure the beam trawl in Thailand start since 1960 era, maybe before 1960. It's very long history in Thailand. But in another country, I have no idea. If you have history of the trawl in your country, you should write it. You can send to our Safe Deck magazine, Fish for the People, to show this article related with the history of the trawl in your country. In Thailand, beam trawl come first, before coming of modern outboard trawl in 1960 period. And the next one is pair trawl. Pair trawl, the name is, definition is directly linked with the name. Pair trawl is the trawl towing by two vessels, use two vessels. With that, it allow construction of the trawl is very huge, very big, bigger than the single trawl, because two boats have two motor, two engine, power double. You can make the trawl bigger. You can trawl it faster. Why pair trawl is not so not so popular because right now every country in this region and in the world try to ban the petrol because its efficiency very high. In Thai, they operate 3 knots, 4 knots, 4 nautical miles. Maybe some trawler can operate up to 5 nautical miles, but mostly 3 or 4 nautical miles per hour. It can drag very long distance with a big mouth, a big distance of the trawl mouth. It very high efficiency fishing gear. Need restrict regulation, needs restrict measures. So that's why petrol not so easy to find the registration right now. So may I show you some more example of trawl type that may interesting is multi-rig trawl is the trawl that use autoboard more than one pair, and the net more than two net, maybe up to three net. Mostly we found three net, but autoboard may up to six pieces, three pair of autoboard. And mostly used in Europe, in Southeast Asia we hardly to find multi-rig trawl. Twin rig trawl or Mexican chim trawl, sometimes we call double rigger. We can find in Malaysia to catch the chim in Sarawak, in Indonesia, eastern part, Papua of Indonesia, used for catch the shrimp. The next slide is anatomy of trawl net, construction of trawl net. Sometimes we call the name different from the fisherman. This is one of the problem that our researcher, when we go to the field and talk with the fisherman, we discuss and we ask for information, and our information is misunderstanding regarding to the name of each part of trawl. So I would like to show you each part of the trawl, what we call. The first one is the warp. Warp or towing warp or towing line. In autoboard trawl, the warp, the towing line is the line or the rope or the steel wire that used to tie at the boat and the another end tie with the autoboard or the trawl door. Meaning is towing warp is the line or the rope or the steel wire that join between boat and autoboard to tow autoboard. So that towing warp must be big enough to resist with the net resistance in the water and autoboard resistance in the water. The next one is the backstrop. The backstrop is the rope or the wire. There are two lines. The top of the autoboard and lower part of the autoboard. This backstrop, normally sometimes when we adjust the autoboard to make it tilt up or tilt down, we can adjust at these two parts. This is fishing technology knowledge or phishing technology information, you can get roughly this information in textbook of FAO, fisherman workbook. You can observe that reference. I will show you in the another part of this presentation, that book. From the backstop, normally there are one small line between backstop and autobot, conjunction between WAF. We call autobot pendant. I don't draw the autobot pendant with this picture, but autobot pendant used for maneuvering during bring the autobot hanging at the boat, not so important in term of fishing operation. In term of fishing efficiency, but important in term of fishing operation. Here. One of the most important part is before sweep line, I better inform you the autobot before. Normally autobot is used to expand the wing of the net, throw net, used to open the mouth of the net. There are various kind of the autobot, starting from the simple one, the rectangular shape one. The complex one look like rectangular, but have some design to use hydrodynamics for expanding the autobot. Or we have some oval shape, autobot oval shape, various kind. I would suggest you to check with the autobot performance, the textbook of FAO. You can search internet free download as PDF file, autobot performance, use the keyword autobot performance FAO, and you can download it. Very good basic for autobot study. And sweep line, this is one of the important for fishery resort researcher or scientist. This sweep line, some fishing gear technologies consider it start efficiency of the trawl, because this sweep line is the line that insert between bottom trawl, autobot to the net. This area normally touch at the seabed and make the fish frighten and escape inside of the net part. In some fishing boat, they calculate the sweep area starting from sweep line. They use the net transponder at the autobot and calculate from that. But some country, they calculate at the tip of the wing net. This is different. You need to check how your country calculate the sweep area starting from the sweep line or autobot or not. And sweep line, someone said there are two additional line. Some people call Braden line, upper Braden, lower Braden. Someone call net pendant, upper net pendant, lower net pendant. But it seems to be the same distance of the sweep line. But if opening is linked with the opening of the net. If sweep line is long, it's intended to be semi-pelagic trawl. If the Bredon short, it's difficult to make the float line higher. It's difficult to make float line higher, so that the upper Bredon for semi-pelagic high opening trawl need this long length.